That's right. Long time we are back. So hope you have revised something at home and not forgotten the stuff. Huh? So because the syllabus is big, so most probably you should revise the stuff now. Since this is online, I think this is helpful because I don't think you should have any problems. If you have any problems, you have the two options or many options to solve your problems. Problems means if you don't have, you can ask me in between if you want to for your audio. You can type a message over there only in your system, or if you still have any issues and if you want to ask me privately, you can ask me through WhatsApp. Okay, so open to that. Now, the good thing is, I don't know, good thing or bad thing, since you can't come travel over here, so sit at home and study. Good thing is that. So now see, most probably what I am planning is, if this continues, so see, they have taken a provision of only 2 weeks, I think. Right, so till 31st March, they have taken a provision that we will not do anything in all those things. So for this coming 2 weeks, I try to have as much classes as I can. Okay, so in this coming 2 weeks, if I have as much classes as I can, what is the good thing over here is, I can cover most of the syllabus over here. So that means by April 1st week or 2nd week, we'll be almost like in a very good position. Because see, I'm telling you again, this tax, if you don't do the revision kit, it is impossible to get through. And revision kit, you have to do with me only. So that means the more time I get for revision kit, the better. Syllabus is big, so in this situation, so almost not every day I will say I'll have the class. But just coming 2 weeks, it will be on a regular basis. Okay, so let's see by March end how much we can complete. If we can complete the entire part B of the content and part C, very nice. Okay, then in April I will have only part D and part E, that is very small. And then straight away we run to the revision kit and do more and more of practice. Okay, so since last class I think we were doing revisions on that chapter, and I should run through the book and right. Today let's start a new chapter. Okay, rather than going again to property, income and all those things, I will do this week only. But let's start chapter number 7, completing reading in class. Okay, so now see, we have already spoken about the first chapter wherein we spoke about the rates of 37,500, 150,000, 20%, 40%, 45%, for dividend 7.5, 32.5, 38.1, 12,500 and all those things. Okay. Keep aside all those mobile phones and ringtones and all. Okay. And then we did about, then we spoke about employment income. So employment income was, remember, I used to give an example. If I do something for executive rent, or if I do some expenses for executive rent, I should be able to subtract it if I don't get the reimbursement. So that means the example of office to home, home to office and all those things. Okay, so that was there in that chapter. Then we spoke about taxable benefits. Taxable benefit number, very important. You get accommodation, then what happens? You get car, then what happens? That list price into CO2 emission. 23% add 3% and then subject to a maximum of 37% petrol car, diesel car. And then we spoke about the petrol also. The value of the petrol was 22,400, if I'm not wrong. Okay, so all 23,400, 22,400. So this time they have changed. So that was taxable benefit. Then we spoke about property income. If I have some rent, then how to deal with that? Accrual basis, cash basis, and then in the rent we had 3 things. Normal letting, furnished holiday letting, and rent a room. So those topics were there. Okay, so most probably I will share that sheet in my WhatsApp only now, the summary of all the chapters. And then we spoke about pension income also. So if I have some pension, then what happens? So pension income was also done. And then lastly we did was national insurance contribution. Class 1, Class 1A, Class 2 and Class 4. Right? So all those things were done. So now that means employee wise I am done. Now talk about employer wise. Employer wise means if I am doing my business, then how much tax I should pay? Same. 37,500, 20%, 40%, 45%. But the question here is, how should I find out my business profit? That is the main thing over here. Because in salary it was very simple. You get the salary, you do minus 12,500 and then you get on with your calculation. But in this one, I have to find out the profit of the business and then only I can move on. So this chapter which I am doing right now, you will get a 50 mark question from this chapter. That means this chapter number 7 is 150 mark question from here for sure. Okay, what kind of questions can come and what kind of adjustments can come, I will tell you. But this is for sure that you have to find out the profit of the business first. That means one big table you have to do, get the profit, And once you get the profit, you have to then tax the profit. So that is quite simple. The main important thing is to get the profit over here. So here we will try to find out how to find out the profit. 15 mark question from here. That's why it is called computing trading income. Trading income means business income, right? Okay. Now, before you start, in the first page you will see that there are various examples to it. Okay. What are the examples? Means, for suppose if I give you certain examples, then you, like, will you understand, is it a business or not a business? For suppose I just give you one example, and then I will bring you to the book now. For example, suppose if I give you, see, execute rent is there. Okay. Now, execute rent is the generally execute rent business is what? To earn profits from the class fees, or to earn the revenue from the class fees. So whatever money they
get. Do we take notes of this, or you will give notes later?
There is no notes for F6.
Okay.
There is no notes for F6. Okay. You have to strictly follow the book. I hope the soft copy is shared, the entire soft copy.
Okay.
Right. So before I start the chapter, I will beforehand, like one day prior, I will tell you which chapter I will start. So if you can get the hard copy of that. Yes. Saying something. Okay. Yes, I tell you. So that means, so see, for example, I give you that execute rent is there. Now this execute rent, the main income of execute rent is from tuition fees. No issues. So whatever money I receive, I will do all the sales minus the cost. I get my profit. From the profit, execute rent will pay the tax. Finished. Now the question here is, what happened once was something like this. First, suppose I tell you that execute rent purchased 1 million tons of tissue paper. But executor is not into tissue paper business, right? It is into what? Teaching business. Now, executor has purchased 1 million tons of tissue paper. Now, the question here is, HMRC will ask you that why did you buy 1 tons of tissue paper or 1 million tons of tissue paper? Is there any reason behind it? Just imagine, why will executor at one go will buy 1 million tons of tissue paper? Doesn't make sense. Right?
Bye.
To the business of that. That means now the HMRC will say what? It is assumed that you are also into the business of selling tissue papers in addition to whatever you are doing. Right? That means you will have certain examples in the theory, not theoretical, 2-mark question, where they will tell you that this was the situation. So is this a trade or not a trade? For suppose, right? So that means, for example, one more example I can give you. So one is tissue paper. Execute is into teaching business. So very nicely they are saying teaching business is trading income, no problem. But tissue paper they are buying 1 million tons but not showing it as trading income. So now HMRC says that what will you do with 1 million tissue paper? We assume that you will sell it. So that means you are also into the business of what? Selling tissue papers and providing classes. That is one situation, right? Then one more example I can give you is, suppose I have the habit of buying shares and selling the shares. Okay. Now the question here is, if I buy the shares, okay, I keep it for 5 years and then I will sell it after 5 years. Okay. Now, so whatever dividends I get in this 5 years will be taxed as what? Dividend income then? Okay. Now the second situation is, I buy the shares and I sell the shares after 1 week. Again, I buy the shares and sell the shares. So that means this rotation keeps on very frequently. So in this situation, 2 situations. One situation was, I buy the share and then I sell it after 5 years. Second situation is, I buy the shares and I sell it after 1 week. Then again I will buy, again I will sell. So in this 2 situation, which one of this will you think is a business for me? The second one? Because the second one says, you buy the shares, you sell the shares. You buy the shares, you sell the shares. That means in this situation, you are into share trading right now. That means whatever incomes you generate from the shares, that will not be treated as dividend income, rather that will be treated as business income. This is one example, right? Now, this entire topic is basically called badges of trade. Badges of trade means, like, all there are 10 examples over here. That means all these 10 examples are giving you a hint. Is this a trade or this is not a trade? Then one more example you will get over here is this. That they will tell you that there were a group of accountants and they were doing accounting work. So whatever I get money from my accounting work, that is my business. So that is business income, no problem. Now what happened was this. These accountants, what did they do is, they purchased one lot of liquor, whiskey basically. Okay, they purchased one lot of whiskey and they sold it and they sold the whiskey now. Now, the HMRC is telling you, see, accountant business, accountant profit, accountant sales, that is business income for you. But what about this sales of whiskey and brandy? So in this situation, accountant is saying, we are not going to sell it brandy and whiskey over here. But the HMRC is saying right now, see, the method you used to sell the whiskey and brandy is the same as a normal dealer would have done it. So we assume that you are into accounting business also and whiskey business also. So that means there are various examples where you need to find out whether you are into this business or not a business. That means they will give you an example and you have to tell them that whether this is trading income or not a trading income. That if it is not a trading income, then what is that? Obviously that is something, but they will, right now we are not into that. That what is that now? So what is that? I will tell you afterwards. So in this situation, the only answer is you have to give is yes or no. Is this trading or is this not a trading? Okay, that means the first 10 minutes or the 15 minutes will go on this theory part only. You will read some points and try to find out that is this trade or is this not a trade for you. Right? That means in summarize from I can tell you, if the transactions are repetitive in nature, it is trading, it is trade for me because I buy, I sell, I buy, I sell. So if the transactions are repetitive in nature, it is a trade for me. If the transaction is not repetitive in nature, it is not a trade for me in that situation. Why? Because to do business should be what? Very frequent in manner. So if these are frequent in manner, it is a trade for me. If it is not frequent in manner, it is not trade for me. So there are various situations now. So let's read the situation. Huh? So see, page number 106. So there are 10 points if you see. Barriers of trade. So I just read this. Huh? It says, the barriers of trade are used to decide whether or not a trade exists. That means you will decide whether it is a trading business or not a trading business. So if one does exist, the accounts profits need to be adjusted in order to establish the taxable profits. If it is a trade, you have to take that into consideration, get the trading profits to find out that. Okay, now.
Sir, what page?
Yes.
What page?
Page number 106.
Okay.
Now, point number one, see, subject matter. So there are various headings. Subject matter, frequency of the transaction. Frequency of the transaction means what? More the frequency of transaction, higher the chances of it becoming a trade. Less the frequency of transactions, lesser the chances of it becoming a trade. The subject matter is the example which I give you, that executor in addition to teaching has purchased 1 million tons of tissue paper. So in this situation, HMRC will assume that you are into selling tissue paper also. Because as executor, you should not require 1 million tons of tissue paper. It is impossible. So that is what it says. See, subject matter. Whether a person is trading or not may sometimes be decided by examining the subject matter of the transaction, not the real matter. So subject matter is 1 million tons of tissue paper for what? Right? If you can't justify that means you are into sales of tissue paper also. So some assets are commonly held as investment for their intrinsic value, and individual buying some shares or a painting may do so in order to enjoy income from the shares or to enjoy work of art. So some people might buy shares for what? For long term. Then it is not trading income. But some people might buy shares for short term. Then it is what? Trading income. A subsequent disposal may produce a gain of a capital nature other than trading profit. But where the subject matter of a transaction is such as would have not been held as investment. For example, whatever it is, 3.4 million yards of aircraft linen or 1 million rolls of toilet paper, is presumed that any profit on resale is a trading profit. That means a company who is into different business, but all of a sudden they buy 1 million tons of tissue paper. That means then it is assumed that this sales of tissue paper is also your trading business, because there is no point you will buy 1 million tons of tissue paper. Okay, so this is subject matter. That means subject matter will decide whether you are trading or not trading. Then frequency of the transaction, more the frequency of the transaction, more chances of it being a trade. So transactions which may be in isolation, be capital of nature, will be interpreted as trading transactions, with their frequency indicates the carrying of a trade. That means more frequency, higher chances of trade, less frequency, lesser chances of trade. Now, it was decided that whereas normally the purchase of a mill owning company and subsequent setting of its asset might be capital transaction, where the taxpayer is, leave out this. That means in summary, because they will not ask you all those things. They will just give you small example. This is just for explanation purpose. So more the frequency of transactions, you can write, more the frequency of transaction, the higher chances of it becoming a trade. Less the frequency of transactions, the lesser chances of it becoming a trade. So if you buy shares, sell shares, buy shares, sell shares on a frequent basis, it is a trade. If you do it once in a year or once in 2 years or 3 years, it is not a trade. It is something else. What is something else? Not mentioned over here. Okay. So do let me know if you have any issue. Then point number three, existence of similar trading transactions or interest. See what it says. If there is an existing trade, then a similarity to the transactions which is being considered may point out that a transaction having a trading character. Now see the example. For example, a builder who builds and sells a number of houses may be held to be trading even if he retains one or more houses for longer than usual and claims them as a investment. Now what is happening over here is, see, I tell you, I am a constructor or I am a builder basically, right? So I am a builder, what do I do? I make buildings for the people now, clients, okay? So what I have done is, I have kept two buildings for myself. I have not sold it, so I constructed it for myself, okay? Or I constructed it for the company now. Now that two buildings, suppose I have constructed 10 buildings, okay? Out of that 10 buildings, 8 is sold. So if 8 is sold, 8 is trading income, no problem. The two, I have kept it for myself. Okay, that means I am not selling it. Now, I will tell the HMRC, say this two, I am not selling it, I am keeping it for myself. HMRC will not assume that fact or not accept that fact. They will say what? Since you are into selling the buildings, even if you keep it for more than 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, we still assume that this two buildings which you have kept is what? Is a trading business only. That means that is called similarity of transactions. You keep it with you, doesn't matter, since you are into selling buildings only, we assume that these two buildings which you have kept is what? Again, trading income. So that is what I'm saying, see? A builder who builds and sells a number of houses may be held to be trading. So you will be trading income only, even if he retains one or more houses. So even if I keep one or more houses for myself, it will still be treated as trading income for me. Then, length of ownership. Now, understand this. I buy this chair for suppose today and I sell this after 7 days. Okay, and second example, if I buy this share and I sell this after 7 years, so which of this do you think will be a trading for me? 7 days or 7 years? I hope we can get the answer.
7 days.
7 days, because again what? The nearer the transactions, the higher the chances of it becoming a trading. The far the transaction, that means what? You are not into trading. You have used the chair for 7 years. Now you are selling it. That is a different story altogether. If you sell it after 7 days, that means what? You are a dealer in chairs. You buy chairs, you sell chairs. So that is what says length of ownership. If the length of ownership is small, it is trading. If the length of ownership is big, it is what? Not trading. So the courts may infer a venture in the nature of trade where items purchased are sold soon afterward. That means when you purchase, you sell it very soon. It is trade for you. So in one word again, small the length of ownership, it is higher chances of it becoming a trade. Bigger the length of ownership, lesser chances of being a trade. Okay, then the example of this, the organization of activity as a trade. See what they are saying. The courts, this is all what court cases, this is what court verdict. They are saying this is trade, that means this is trade. You cannot say why and how. Even if you don't agree, you have to agree because the court has already said all this. Now, the courts may infer that trade is being carried on if the transactions are carried out in the same manner as someone who is unquestionably trading it. For example, an individual who bought a consignment of whiskey and then sold it to an agent in the same way as the others who were carrying on a trade was also had to be trading. On the other hand, if the asset is sold to raise funds in an emergency, there is less likely to be trading. That means what is the situation is, I was into some other business, I bought whiskey and I sold it in the same manner as a whiskey dealer would do it. So that means for me, even the sale of whiskey is what? Is the sale of whiskey is also a trading income for me. So I am into executive trade, I bought a consignment of whiskey, I sold it in the same manner as a normal whiskey dealer would do it. That means what? For me, the sale of whiskey is also what? A trading income for me. Now, if I do it, the last line says, if I do it for emergency use, maybe if some emergency is there and I'm doing it once in a while, then obviously they can say the fund is not trading income for you. Now, if it is not trading income, then what income? Obviously it is an income, but not trading income for sure, some other income. So it doesn't mean that they will not tax you. They will surely tax you, but not in trading income head, in some other head. Remember, we had employment income, salary income, property income, and all those, right? So there are so many slabs we have, so many heads we have. So if I don't tax you in trading income, I will tax you in some other income. Okay? So my, right now, our point is what? Is it trading income or not? That is what you want. Then, supplementary work and marketing. I can summarize this. Supplementary work and marketing is same thing. See, I am executive trained, so I am teaching now. Suppose I have bought this, maybe chairs and tables. Now, I am doing, to sell these chairs and tables, I am doing the same marketing and distribution process as a normal dealer would. That means if you do normal, as executive trained, I should do marketing of my teaching, not of my chairs and tables. So if you are doing marketing of your chairs and tables also, that means what it is, trading income for chair and tables also. In addition to your normal classes. So that means if I am doing marketing of my classes, well and good, I should do it. But if I am doing marketing and distribution of my chairs and tables also, you are advertising your tables and chairs also. In addition to your classes, that means you are into two business. You are into classes business and you are into chairs and tables. That is what marketing and distribution is saying. Basically. Then, profit motive. Profit motive is that if you have profit motive, is it sales? And if you don't have profit motive, is it sales? What do you think? That means suppose I am selling this. If I have a profit motive, is it sales for me? And if I don't have a profit motive, it is sales for me or not? See, in business, you can have profit also, you can have loss also. Agree to this? In business, you can have profit also, you can have loss also, right? That means profit motive is irrelevant to decide whether you are trading in some goods or not trading in some goods. You cannot have that pretext that since I have had a loss in selling this, this is not a trading income. Okay? That means profit motive is irrelevant to decide whether you are trading or not trading. Okay? So profit motive is not at all relevant to decide whether I am doing business or not doing business. Because from business point of view, you can have profit, you can have loss also. Profit motive is irrelevant. That is what the profit motive says. So you should just know the summary of all those things. You don't have to write any definition from this visa. Then, the way in which the asset sold was acquired. Now see, understand this. I'll give a very good example of this. 1.8. See, I purchase this building and I then sell this building. Okay, situation number one. I purchase this building and then I sell this building. This is situation number one. Situation number two is, I got this building through inheritance, that means through will. It was of my grandfather, then it was of my father, and then I got this building from there. And now I sell this building. So out of this two situation, where in first situation I purchase the building and I sell the building, and in the second situation, I get the building through inheritance, and then I sell the building. So in this two situation, which one of you think, which of this you think is a sales for me, or trading for me? The first one?
Yeah.
Yes, because first one is what? You are buying the building and you are selling the building. So it is the first one basically. In the second one, I am not into the business of selling the building. Since I got it through my inheritance, maybe I had an extra building, I sold it normally. So that means it is not trading income for me. It is what? It is now. Now, first condition, they will tax me as business income. Second condition, they can't tax me as business income or trading income. So does it mean that they will not tax me? They will surely tax me, not in business income, but in which chapter? Inheritance tax chapter. Right? So you are not saved at all. It doesn't mean that it is not over here, then it is never, it is nowhere. It's not like that. It is not over here means it is somewhere else. So if you get a building, if you buy a building and sell a building, we will tax you as trading income. If you get a building through inheritance and then sell it and you have a profit, we will tax you not as business income, but we will tax you as inheritance income. So our motive here is to find out trading or not trading, that's it. What is, if it is not trading, then what is it? That is not the point of concern as of now. Okay? So that is called the way in which the asset sold was acquired. So if you purchase and sell it, trading. If you get through inheritance and sell it, not trading. Okay? Then method of finance. Method of finance is something like this. See, very simple. Method of finance is, I want to purchase the building for 1 million. Okay? I don't have money. I want to purchase the building for 1 million. I don't have the money. Right? So what do? I go to the bank. I take a loan of 1 million and then I buy this building. Okay? This is the situation. Now you tell me, I will give you two situations now. So you tell me which one is business and which one is not a business. So see, I have one, I want to purchase a building, I don't have money. I go to the bank, I take a loan of 1 million, I purchase the building. Now, what did I say to the bank? I told the bank that this loan which I am taking from you, I will return you this entire 1 million money in 3 months. This is situation 1. Okay? And situation 2 is, I have told the bank, this 1 million which I have taken from you, I will return this in 25 years. So out of this 3 options of 3 months and 25 years, which is business for you, trading for you?
3 months.
3 months? Because see, all of a sudden, how will you get 3 months? 1 million in 3 months. You can only get this money by selling the building. Because right now, if I don't have 1 million, in 3 months I can't get 1 million all of a sudden. That means how can you confirm the bank that you will give the money in 3 months? You can only confirm by what? By selling the building. That means for sure in 3 months I can sell the building. Right? But when you say I will give in 25 years, that means obviously you are not going to sell the building. You will give this money to your salary only. Right? So this 1 million will be paid in 25 years before. I will pay this money from my salary. That means the first portion of 3 months, that is basically called trading income, and this is called non-trading income. So that means methods of finance. Methods of finance is, if the finance is taken for short term, it is business. If the finance is taken for long term, 25 years, then it is not business. Because you will pay the finance, you will repay the finance loan through what? Through your salary. Okay? Then, the last point. Taxpayer's intentions. Your intention is irrelevant to the HMRC. You have the intention of trading, you don't have the intention of trading, they will never look at that. What they will look at right now is more the subject matter basically. See, remember, we gave an example that Execute Rain was teaching. So teaching is a normal business, right? But it has purchased 1 million tons of tissue paper. Execute Rain will never accept that we are into selling tissue paper. That means my intention is bad. But what is the subject matter saying? The subject matter is saying that 1 million tons of tissue paper, what will Execute Rain do? Obviously, will not use it. For sure, you will sell it. That means you are also into the business of, in addition to teaching, you are also into the business of selling tissue papers. Right, so that means my intention is not important to HMRC. What is important to HMRC is the subject matter. So the intention of the taxpayer is irrelevant for HMRC. Right, they will focus on what the entire situation is all about. This is a theory basically. That means these are the various situations which tells you, is it a trade or is it not a trade? Okay, now we come to that important part of the story, which is page number 108. Which is page number 108. Very important. See. 108, here it tells you the most important thing. That means you have to find out the profit pool. So business has to pay tax. If the business has to pay tax, that means business needs to get profit from there, right? So the first fight is. Yes, the first fight is that you have to find out the profit of the business. Now, how do I find out the profit of the business? That is only 15 months. That means you have to find out the profit of the business. Once you get the profit, then finding out the tax is very easy. That is 7,500, 150, 20, 40, 45. That I'm only able to do. No problem. Now, how do I do this? Now, since you have already done accounts, something in F3 and all those things, see this. There are the method. The method of finding profit in accounts is different from the method of finding out profit in tax. Okay. Now, when I have executed as a business, when it will make its statements, that means it will make the sales minus the cost and you will get the profit, right? That will be done as per the accounting terms. Fine. But the tax department has a different method of finding out the profits. That means account method and tax method are two different things. What we prepare is accounting point of view. What tax department wants is from the tax point of view. That means when you are paying the tax, they will tell you or they will ask you the profit which you have got. Is this as per accounting terms or taxation terms? If you do as per accounting terms, they will never accept it because you have to get the profit as per taxation terms. Okay. So in the question, in the exam, in the question, they will always give you the profit as per accounts. What you have to do is you have to convert that profit as per accounts to profit as per tax. So that means there's basically there are different treatments of accounts and tax. See, I will show you a small example. So this is very important to understand, because this is very important. 15 mark question you get from here first year, and concept is easy. I can't say very easy, but a bit tricky. Let's see. See this. I am making as per accounts. Okay, I am making this as per accounts. Now see, what you will write is, I hope you have seen this something like this. You will write revenue over here. Suppose 10,000. I hope you can see 10,000. Then we do a minus. Suppose purchases. Suppose purchase was 4,000. So you get 6,000. What is the 6,000%? Gross profit. Okay. Then from this gross profit, you paid some expenses. Let's say I guess you paid rent of 1,000. Then you paid salary of 500. Then you paid a fine. Fine means you broke some law, and for that law you are paying some fine. So you paid some fine of suppose 1,500. Okay. What else I can get? Let's keep it over here. Then I tell you more things. Now, then what is the net profit? Net profit is actually 3,000. So now this net profit as per accounts is what, 3,000 rupees. Agreed? Now this entire statement will be given to you in the exam. This entire statement of accounts. I hope this format is fine with you, because this is the format I will use. So this entire format will be given to you, and net profit will be given to you, 3,000. Now, when you take this 3,000 and you will go to the tax department and tell them what? See, I have to pay tax on 3,000, right? The tax department, first thing they will ask you is this 3,000 as per accounting terms or as per taxation terms? So you will say what? Accounting terms. They will say, we don't agree with this accounting terms. You have to find out tax as per taxation terms. Now, what is the difference between taxation and accounting difference? Now, difference is something like this. Very few differences. Small difference. And the other differences will be very clearly in the question given. Now see, the first difference which I will tell you is that the fines which you have minus over here, that means accounts is saying what? Fine is an expense for me, right? The taxation law says any payment which you know. Why do you pay fine? You pay fine because obviously you have broken the law. Because when do you pay the fine? Because maybe of you have broken some law, maybe you have not paid the tax on time, maybe you have done something like that, right? Penalty. So the law says that any payment, okay, any payment made towards the infraction of law. Infraction is the word they use in the book. Infraction means if you break the law, and if you make any payment for that, the tax department says we don't treat this as an expense. Okay, the tax department says we don't treat this as an expense. We cannot allow you to subtract from there. So that means, if first of all, now understand this. That means if you have to make this once again with tax point of view, you will write 10,000 here. Purchases, even tax has no problem with purchase, we are fine with that. Rent, they are saying no issues, 1,000 is fine. Salary, they are saying 500 fine. They are saying fine, we can't give it to you. It's not an expense for us. But tax says fine is not an expense. Though you have paid it, we don't treat this as an expense. So that means as per taxation terms, what is the profit you have? 4,500. So that means you have to pay tax on what? 4,500. Is this clear? Okay. Now the question here is, you can't be doing it like this. I can't be, this is the correct answer by the way, but I can't be doing it like this. So how do I do it? See, you have to always, this is the correct method of doing it. That means you have to find out the tax profit. So how do you find out the tax profit? You have to start with the net profit as per accounts. So what is the net profit as per accounts? 3,000. And then you have to do a back calculation now. They have subtracted 1,500. Will you subtract 1,500? No. That means what do I do? I will add 1,500 because they have already subtracted. Because see, I get this 3,000 by subtracting all these figures. Okay. That means now the tax will say that if I would have done it, I would have never subtracted 1,500. These guys have already subtracted. So what do? You will add the fines. Then next number four, salary. So the tax is what? And the tax relax accounts, you have subtracted, even I would have subtracted. So no problem with that. Even rent, they don't have any problem with that. Even purchases, they don't have any problem with that. That means what is the profit after tax? 4,500. This is how to do it. You cannot do from straight away because sometimes sales will not be given to you. You have to do a back calculation and then come to that situation. That means there are certain expenses which are allowed to be subtracted from tax point of view or accounts point of view, but they are never allowed to be subtracted from tax point of view. That means if you want to get the profit, you have to add those expenses. You have to add back those expenses to get the profit of what? To get the profit of tax. Are you getting this? So I will give you many examples now, like this. And then you have to keep in mind what is allowed in accounts and not allowed in tax. If it is not allowed in tax, you add back. So the only first thing you have to understand is this method, because many students don't get familiar with this method. This method is very important. You have to start with net profit of accounts and do a back calculation and then get the profit. So I got 4,500 by doing a normal calculation in the second column. You have to do the third column and get the profit of, see, again I'm getting 4,500 only, but this is the correct method, not this. Both are giving the same answers, but this is the correct method. You have to start with 3,000 and whatever mistakes they have done, you have to reverse the mistakes. So if they have subtracted and you are not allowed to subtract, you will add back. They have subtracted, even you would have done the same thing, no problem. That means if your treatment and my treatment is still the same, you will not do anything ignorant. Okay, but if there is a difference in your treatment, my treatment, so whatever you have done, I will reverse that. So if you have subtracted, I will add. Maybe you have added, I will subtract. Okay, now one more example if I want to give you this then. Suppose here they paid something like extortion money. Extortion money means like maybe the director of the company was kidnapped. Okay, so if he was kidnapped, now he had to release that director. The company paid 5,000 to release the director. So that is basically extortion money now. So accounts will say what? Expense for the business. See, if I get kidnapped over here, executor pays 10,000 to release me. That means for executor it is an expense 10,000, right? So that means in this situation, executor, suppose it was 1,000, so executor will minus 1,000 from here. And then they will say the profit is how much? 2,500. But again, taxation department says what? Any illegal payments. Extortion is what? Illegal. Black money, bribe money, extortion money, illegal payments. Taxation says any illegal payments we will not allow you to subtract. So as per the simple calculations, you will do like this. 4,500. Because fine is already there, you can't subtract. That means in this situation, what will I do? Net profit 3,000, and I will talk about extortion money. Extortion money, tax says no. So add extortion money because you have subtracted. What will I do? I will add back. Then fines, 1,500, tax is what? Any payment towards infraction of law, we cannot allow you to subtract. They will add back 1,500. Salary is fine with me. You have to minus it. I will have done the same thing. Okay, I am tax. Rent, you have minus 1,000. Even I would have done the same thing. So we keep it just like that. That means the answer is what now? Check. What is this number? 6 minus, what is this? 4,500?
The first one should be 2,000.
What?
The first one, it should be 2,000, right? The total?
I have no idea. I need to see. 6 minus 2,000. 2,000. And how much is this then? 4,500? Now why it is not coming 4,500? Achha, 2,000. Yeah, 2,000. So this is 2,000. Then this, how much do I get here? 4,500. Let me see. This column and this column will match. But you can't do this like this. You cannot do a straight method. You have to do a back calculation and then come for you. Do you get this? Now, one more important is this. In accounts, what do we subtract? Depreciation. Depreciation is an expense, right? So in accounts, you will subtract depreciation. Okay? tax has its own method of depreciation. That means whatever depreciation you have subtracted, we will not allow you to subtract over here. Whatever depreciation amount is subtracted, we will add back. Okay, we will add back. Why? Because the tax says depreciation you have to find out as per my rules. Okay, and in, that is the next step we will do. That means in tax, we don't call this as depreciation. We call this as capital allowances. So we don't call this as depreciation, we call this as capital allowances. So the tax department says what? Depreciation if you have subtracted, we will add back. And what we will subtract capital allowances from here. And capital allowances we have to find out. That is one big chapter, again next chapter. To find out depreciation from tax point of view. But easy, interesting. So that means one major difference is what? See, what things are not allowed in account, allowed in accounts, but not allowed in tax. So see what will happen. Any payment towards infraction of law, account will subtract, I will add back. Any payments for illegal money, that means bribe, extortion, all those things, account will subtract, I will add back. He will subtract depreciation, I will add back. Why? Because I will subtract depreciation as per my method. That is basically called capital allowances. In this chapter, they will directly give you the figure of capital allowances. Because till now, I don't know how to find that answer, that capital allowance, right? So till now, they will give me over here. Next chapter, you have to find out the depreciation. That is why, see, that is why this is a 15 mark question. Why? Because for capital allowances, only you have to do one big working over there. So when once you do that big working, you get the depreciation as per tax, then you come and subtract over here. And then you will have a long list of plus minus also. That means long list of plus minus, and then you will have what? You will have a depreciation. And then if this comes out to be loss, it can come out to be loss also. So till now I have not discussed loss. So loss has a different rule now. So that means very much justified of a 15 mark chapter. Because you will have that long list of plus minus, plus minus, plus minus. And then what will happen? You have to find out depreciation, big one. And then if you have a loss, then another method of setting up the loss. So that means 15 mark question quite justified. At least you will take 45 minutes to solve the sum. But the plus minus is very easy. You have to keep in mind. Okay? Now let us see one more example. For suppose. So I will remove this question because this is wrong. This is answer was is correct, but method was is wrong. Now, see, this is 2000. Now see, what else they can tell you? There are something which is like quite direct. Direct means fine penalty, I know not allowed. Okay? Extortion money, I know not allowed. Depreciation, I know not allowed to be subtracted. Not allowed means not allowed to be subtracted. So I will add back, add back. Okay? Now there can be some extra information. Extra information is something like this. See, they are telling you that the salary which was paid, how much was salary? 500. So it says the salary which was paid to the owner's wife or owner's relative. Okay? And if it would have been paid to someone else, they would have only paid 400. Do you get the question? The question is, the salary paid over here, 500, is paid to the owner's relative. If it was paid to someone else, that means if someone else was working in place of relative, the normal market rate was only 400. That means, can I say they have given extra 100 to the relative?
Yeah.
Yes, that means if the salary was 400 over here, then the profit would have been 2100. So that means in this situation, what will I do? Can I do add extra salary? Because can I say that instead of subtracting 400, you have subtracted how much? 500? You should have subtracted how much? 400? So how to reverse that effect? So you cannot do a minus 400 over here because that is not allowed. So what do I do? So since you have already done a minus 400, you should do what? Minus, if you have done what? Minus 500, you should do what? Minus 400. So if in my working, if I do a plus 100, then can I say the effect is justified? What do you say?
Yes.
That means extra salary will be added. Let me see, here there are no rules to it. The question will only tell you, that means you will have to understand, okay, fine. He has given extra salary to the relative. That means tax department says extra salary is not allowed to give. You should have given only 400. So you should have subtracted 400. But account subtracted how much? 500. So how to reverse that effect? I need to do what? Minus 400. So how to reverse that effect? I need to do a plus 100. That means minus 500 plus 100 is equal to what? minus 400. And since you are starting from what, 2000, so all this 2000 has taken everything into effect. So what do you do? You do the reversal of that. Is this fine? We will do a sum of this one. We will also do a sum of this today, most probably. I will not finish the chapter, two classes, today and tomorrow. But you have to understand this concept. Now, a few more examples is, now see, the only common thing is bad debts. Bad debts means, if bad debts happen over here, they will subtract, even they will subtract, no problem. For all the other things, you have to see the adjustments. So now see, that means any penalty, any infraction of law, any extra payment to relative is not allowed to be subtracted. That means what? You will add back over here. Do you get this method first? Because I do a sum on this, but this method is important. Once you get this method, and I will talk about the adjustments now, plus, minus, okay. Once that plus, minus is good, then only I will bring you to a sum. Can we move on? Don't worry, you will take some time. If you have not understood, you will take some time to gradually take this, right? But you will have to start someday or sometime. But we have started this now. You will take some time to understand this plus minus bit, plus minus.
Okay. Mommy! Right.
What's this?
We don't do this yet.
Can we please mute your audio that get some shouting from the background? Okay. So basically, you know, see. Now, what can also happen is this, see, I tell you. I'll take one more example. See. So suppose I am doing the accounting profit of executed report, suppose. Okay. Now, what executed has done is minus purchases of 4000. So that gives me how much? 6000. Okay. Then they have done minus salary of 1000. No problems. Now, what executed has done is, for suppose executed in this year sold one building. Okay. For suppose executed rent sold one building. Now what is executed rent basically? Teaching. So what is my normal business? Teaching business. Okay. Now what executed rent has done is, executed rent sold one building and made a profit of 2000 on that building. Okay. So executed rent sold one building this year and made a profit on the building. So in accounts, what did they do? They wrote add profit on sale of building. How much? 2000. And based on that, they are saying my profit is how much? 7000. Okay. Now, when you come to the tax portion, you have to start with 7000. Can't tell you. You always have to start with 7000. You cannot do a straight away method. You have to start from here and then do back calculation. Right? You have to meet everyone on the way. So that means I will start with what? Net profit as per accounts. So net profit as per accounts is what? 7000. Now come with the sum. Now see, understand this. This 7000 has the effect of 2000 also. Yes, this 7000 profit has the effect of this 2000 also. And that is why it has come towards 7000, right? Now my question to you is this 2000 trading profit or non-trading profit?
Non-trading.
Non-trading profit, see, because executed should earn profit from this tuition classes and all those things, right? This classes, not from sale of building. That means sale of building is obviously it is a profit for me, but not trading profit for you. And here we are trying to find out what? The question, the chapter name is computing trading profit. So here we are trying to find out your trading profit, not the non-trading profit. So that means any other profit you have, property, income and all those things, that will be taxed separately. So I am here to find out your business profit, not the non-business profit. So can I say this 2000 is a non-business profit? Because it is what? Profit on sale of building. We are not in the business of selling buildings over here. If I get a profit, obviously it is not a business profit for me. That means if this was not there, my profit would have been 5000. Right? Then what do I do? I will do what? Minus profit on sale of building. How much? 2000. and then as per taxation terms, 5,000 is what? 5,000 is my trading profit. Exact trading profit is 5,000. It doesn't mean that 2,000 will not be taxed. 100% will tax you, not over here, somewhere else. Where is that somewhere else? That is basically chargeable gains. That chargeable gains will go over sometime. Leave out that. So do you get this? That means any profit, because see, account has only one head. That is the profit and loss account. But taxation has so many heads. We have got employment income, trading income, property income, pension income, dividend income, right? So, so many heads are there. That means all these profits will come and sit under one head basically. So that an account doesn't have so much of bifurcation. So it takes everything into one book. And what does tax do? Tax will take into the separate heads now. Trading income you will take separately. Property income will take separately. Salary income will take separately. Pension income will take separately. So separately get to. So is this fine? That means whatever is added over here has to be subtracted over here. Why? Because it should not form part of your trading profit. Keep that in mind. I am here to find out my trading profit only, not the total profit. Okay, I am here to find out the trading profit, not the total profit. That means, now if you come to that sheet now, and I will do step by step so that you understand. See, illustrative adjustments. Okay, page number 108. Page 108. Illustrative adjustment. See, although the net profit 7,000. Okay. Although the net profit shown, I am reading that 2.1. Yeah, section 2.1. Although the net profit shown in the statement of profit and loss is the starting point in computing taxable trade profits. Agree to the fact? Yes. It says what? See, I am reading page number 108, section 2.1. It says what? See, although the net profit, this 7,000 in all my board, okay? Although the net profit shown in the profit and loss account, that means 7,000 is the starting point. Here is the starting point to find out my tax. Taxable profits. Agree to this? That means this will be given to you in the question. And adjustments will be given to you. That salary paid was extra, you had paid fines and all those things will be given to you, right? So you have to start with 7,000 and then do all the consideration what you can do for all the adjustments given to you in 10%. And then you can come to this profit. So that is what it says. Then many adjustments may be required to calculate the taxable amount. Plus minus of the calculation. Okay? Now, they have just given a format to this, but the format is useless. Because once you read the questions and adjustments, you get to know plus or minus. Okay, but let's see. They are saying you will do what? You will start with net profit. That means 3.7 thousand. They are adding 140,000. That means just an arbitrary figure they are. 140 was the profit as per accounts. Then they are adding some income which is taxable as trading profit has not been included in the accounts. You will add that. That means they are saying there was one income which the accounts did not add. Okay, there was one income which the accounts did not add, but the tax is saying what? You should add that income. So what will I do? I can add over here. Okay, that is the point number one. Income taxable as trading profits, okay, which has not been included in the accounts. That means income which should have been taxed over here is not included over here. That means if you don't add over here, but tax is what? You don't add, doesn't matter. I will surely add. You will add over here. Then, the second one. Then, second word, expenditure charged in accounts, okay, not deductible for trading profits. Remember the example, fine. Fines and extortion money, right? Point number one. Fines and extortion money, what is that? Expenditure charged in accounts. That means expenditure subtracted from here, but not allowed to be subtracted from here. What do I do? Add that? You get this, just try to relate my first thing. See, net profit 140,000. With 140,000, what do I add? I add first thing, expenditure charged in accounts. Remember we said over here, fine. We said fines over here, right? So that they are saying expenditure charged in accounts, charged means minus. And obviously this is not allowed to be subtracted over here. So what do? You add that. So when it comes over here, you will do a what? A plus with this. So you add back, and the second thing is what saying what? An income which should have been included in accounts, but they have not included it. So what will the tax say? They will say what? We'll add it. So they will add the income basically. Right? So this is just, they have summarized it. There will be a long list. Long list means with the sums you will understand. Don't worry. Keep on hold. Then what will you subtract? See, what have I subtracted? Profit. Profit in accounts which are not allowed as or which are not considered as profit in tax department. That means what? Can I say profit on sale of building? Accounts added, but tax is what? It is not trading profit. So we will not tax you over here. We will tax you somewhere else. So that can be subtracted. So see that example, profits included in accounts, this one, 2000, profit included in accounts, but which are not taxable as trading profits. So we will subtract that 2000 from here. Agree to me? Yeah. Then the last one, expenditure deductible from trading profits. From here, expenditure which are allowed to be subtracted from here, but you don't write it over here. Only one example, depreciation. See, we will write, instead of depreciation, what we will write? Capital allowances. Because that's the name of depreciation is tax report. Capital allowances, right? So this will be subtracted. You don't find this capital allowances in that column. Because what do you find over there? You find depreciation over there. So depreciation will add, capital allowances will be subtracted. So that is again that example. Expenditure which is not subtracted, deductible from trading profits, but has to be charged in account. That means you have to charge over here. The best example is capital allowance. Is this fine? And then after that it starts all those things. What all those things? That what is to be subtracted, what is not to be subtracted. Fines, penalties and all those things that you have to see. So is the format clear right as of now? Your starting point has to be net profit. You will add something to it. You will subtract something from it. Based on what? Based on what the accounts has done. Based on that, I will do all the reversals now. If required, if not required, if your treatment and my treatment is same, no problem. If your treatment and my treatment is different, we will do that adjustments required. Okay, now there are like certain things fixed. That means your treatment and my treatment will differ. For example, the fine, the extortion money, your depreciation, I can never subtract your depreciation. So what will I do? I will add that and I will subtract my depreciation. And my depreciation is basically called capital allowances. Right, so there are some differences which you will have for sure, and there are some differences which they will create. That means salary to wife or salary to relative. See, if it is normal salary, 1000, I will also do 1000, no problem. But if the salary is given to relative and it should be not 1000, it should be about 800, then I will have a problem with that. So there will be some differences which are by default. That means there will be a difference for sure. Fines, penalties and all those things. Depreciation, there has to be a difference. And there will be some differences which they will intentionally create. Salary paid, extra salary paid and all those things. Okay? Now, one important thing on salary is something like this. Okay. Then I read the book. I am writing over here is salary 1000. Okay.
Come on.
And net profit is 5000. Okay. Again. Now see. Which is this year, by the way? April 6, 1920 to April 5, 2020. Okay. Now see. That means this year which we are talking about is, hope you remember, April 6, 2019 till April 5, 2020. Net profit will start as per accounts. How much? 5000. Okay. Now see, understand this. For this year, we will do a chapter on this, but keep this in mind. For this year, that means this year, April 6, 19 to April 5, 20, what is the date of paying the tax? What is the date of paying the tax? The date of paying the tax is 31st for our year. Okay? The date of paying the tax for this year is 31st January 2021. 9 months from the end of the year. Okay, we will do a chapter on this. So again, I will bring you the entire concept over here, but just this one data I require right now will make you explain this concept. So for this year, my last date of paying tax is 31st January 2021. That means on 31st January 2021, you will go to the HMRC and you will pay the tax on whatever amount given. Okay? Now understand this. When you go on 31st January 2021 to HMRC, they will ask you one question. If they see salary in your account, they will ask you one question. Has this salary been paid or not paid? Okay? They will ask you. So people see, in accounts we follow what accrual concept. That means paid, not paid doesn't matter. Even in tax we follow same thing. Accrual concept also. Paid, not paid doesn't matter. That's also same thing. Only property income cash basis. Remember, only property income cash basis. When do we do accrual basis for property income? When do we do property income accrual basis? When the rent is more than 150,000. When the rent is more than 150,000 in a year, I will follow accrual basis. Right? When I am a company, I will follow accrual basis. Here I am talking about individuals. Huh? And when if I personally want to go for accrual basis, I can go for accrual basis. No problem. Okay? Now see, generally property income is cash basis. All other things are accrual basis. Now see, that means accrual basis means what? Paid, not paid doesn't matter. Okay? So that means accounts say what? Paid, not paid doesn't matter. 1000, you subtract, you get 5000. Now when you go to the HMRC on the last day, that means after 9 months, then HMRC will ask you, did you pay this salary or not paid? If you say it is paid, they are fine with it. Even they get subtracted, so 5000 is good. If you say that this salary is still unpaid, then they will say that we don't treat this as an expense for you. Only for salary it is cash basis, rest all the expenses are accrual basis. So salary they will ask you on the last day, did you pay the salary or not? If it is still due, they will say it is not an expense. We can't treat this as an expense. So you will add back unpaid salary. You will add back unpaid salary of 1000 and you have to pay tax on 6000. This is you have to keep in mind. If the salary is not paid on the last day, what is the last day? 31st January 2021, it has to be added back. Is this fine? That concept is referring to what? Unpaid remuneration. Unpaid remuneration. Now after that, I can discuss all the adjustments and show you step by step. Okay? Yes, sir?
What if the salary, if you are paying it like... For example, this year we are paying a salary of the last year, like 2 months of last year or something. So we will deduct it here?
No. I see. For this year is ending what? April 20?
Okay.
Yes. So for, and when will you go to HMRC? You will go to HMRC on 31st January 2021. That means to clear the salary of this year, I am giving you 9 months from.
Okay.
If you clear within 9 months, no problem. If you don't clear within 9 months, we will add back. Now, if you pay this salary after 5 years, for suppose, this unpaid salary, if you pay this after 5 years, then after 5 years, you can subtract 1000 from it.
Okay.
Right? So that means when I go on the last day and you tell that salary is unpaid, you will not subtract. They will add back. Now, when you actually pay the salary, maybe after 10 years, 20 years, in that year, you will subtract this 1000. Because you will remind HMRC that see that time I did not pay this, so you added back. Now you subtract. Now come to this page number 109.
So which notes are these?
Uh-huh.
Which notes are these?
I can't get you.
The notes.
Yes, the notes. You have not got the soft copy?
No, I don't have them.
He shared in the group, in the F6 group. Check.
Okay, I'll check.
F6 group, right?
Yeah.
He shared the entire book. He shared the entire soft copy.
Okay,
he shared the soft copy of the entire book. So, and I told in the group also previously, like in the afternoon, that we will do chapter number 7. So whatever chapters I do till the time you get the books, whatever chapter I do, I tell you beforehand so that you can get hold of this. And the entire book is there in the group. So please check that. Okay. Okay.
Okay.
Now, that means now we have to talk about that. What are the expenses which can be subtracted? What are the expenses which will not be subtracted? You have to add that. So basically, you see, the word is deductible and non-deductible. Deductible means what? Deductible means, we don't know about this one, huh? The second of the second story, the tax story. So now it is basically, see, deductible means allowed to be subtracted or allowed to be deducted, and non-deductible means what? Not allowed to be subtracted. So if the accounts has already subtracted, I will add back. Do you get that? So allowed to be subtracted. So if it is not subtracted, I will subtract. Not allowed to be subtracted means if they have subtracted it, I will add back. Because whatever the accounts has done, I will do a reverse treatment of that. So if they have subtracted, I will add. If they have minus, I will. If they have plus, I will do a minus. Because we have a differential treatment. Okay. So deductible means allowed to be subtracted. Non-deductible means not allowed to be subtracted. Okay. Let's see. Disallowable. Disallowable means disallowed to be subtracted. That means not allowed to be subtracted. See, all the technical words are like this. So disallowable means not allowed to be subtracted. Okay. So disallowable expenditure must be added back because it is not allowed to be subtracted. So if they have subtracted, I will add back. So disallowed expenditure needs to be added back, okay, to the net profit in computation of taxable trading profit. And any item not deducted, that means any item which has not been subtracted wholly and exclusively for the trade purpose is disallowable expenditure. Certain other items such as depreciation are specifically disallowed. That means what? Depreciation they will subtract. What will I do? I will add back. Accounts will do what? Minus depreciation. I can't do minus depreciation over here. Why? Because I will do minus capital allowances. So that's right. Why? Because my depreciation is something else. So your depreciation I will add back and my depreciation I will minus. What is the name of my depreciation? Capital allowances. So if you allow both this depreciation and this also, then it happens what? That means you are doing two times. Which is wrong. Same expenses you are subtracting two times. So your expense of depreciation I can't allow. So what I will do? I will subtract from you. And what I will subtract is my depreciation. And my depreciation is basically called capital allowances. Is this fine? Let's see. Introduction. Certain expenses are specifically disallowed by legislation. That means specifically not allowed to be subtracted. For example, remember that fine, penalty and all those things, right? So these are covered below. Let's see. Point number one. Payment contrary to public and illegal payments. See, fines and penalties. Remember? Not allowed to be subtracted. What do? I add back. Not deductible means what? Add back. So if they have subtracted fines and penalties, I will add. But very important line is this now. See, check this. Very small thing which you have to keep in mind. Huh? Fines and penalties are not deductible. That means I will add back. However, very important. See, however, usually HMRC usually allows employees parking fines incurred in parking their employer's car while on their employer business. What do I mean by this? See, understand this. Executrain was there. Okay. Now, the owner of the business.
So what page?
Which? 109.
Okay.
109, okay?
Okay.
Section 2.3.2. Now see what are the things? Get this two lines, very important lines. Very small but critical. It says, see, executrain was there. Owner went out with his car and he had to pay a parking fine of 1,000. Understand this. Owner went out with his own car, executrain, and he paid a fine of 1,000. In accounts, he will subtract 1,000. Because for account, it is what? Expense for the business? 1,000. Will tax allow that 1,000?
No.
No, because it is what? Payment made for infraction of law. So 1,000 will be added. No issue. Second example, see this. I am an employee of executrain. I go out for office work. Okay? And now I have to pay a fine of 1,000. And executrain is paying on my behalf. That 1,000. So again, executrain will do a fine of 1,000 over here. Expense for you. In this situation, the tax department says what? It is allowed to be subtracted. No need to do any changes. So if employee is paying the fine, or if the fine is because of employee, for the employer, then 1000 keep on hold, don't add back. But if the owner is paying that 1000 for himself, then you have to add back. That is the two lines. See, now it will make sense. See, fines and penalties are not subtracted, that means added back. However, HMRC usually allows employees parking fines incurred in their parkings, their employer's cars while on their employer business. That means if employee is paying the fine and employer is paying on their behalf, you can subtract from here for sure. You will also subtract from here. That is what? Since they have already subtracted, I will do treatment. Because I will ask the accountant, have you subtracted? They will say yes. And I will ask myself, will I do the same thing? Yes. That is what? If they have already subtracted, I don't have to do anything. When will I do the change? Will I do something different from you? If you do the same thing as I have done, I will skip it. But if I have some changes to do, then only I will do it plus minus. Okay? Now, and if it was normal employer fine, so he has subtracted, so I will ask him, have you subtracted? He said yes. I will do what? I will say what? I would have never subtracted. So what I will do? I will add. Because he's already subtracted over here, so I will add. Is this clear? Plus minus effect, very important. 15 mark question. Then see, fines relating to traders, however, are not allowed. That means if fine is paid by employer, not allowed. Trader, no, so business, not allowed. Then next one. A payment is not deductible if making it constitutes an offense by the payer. That means what? If you are making any payment, which is an offense. Offense means what? Bribe, extortion money, all those things. These are not an offense. So if you have subtracted from here, we will add back. Because any payment, illegal payment, not allowed. Any payment made for the contraction of law or infraction of law, not allowed. That means add back if the accounts are subtracted. So it says what? A payment is not deductible if making it constitutes an offense by the payer. This covers protection money paid to terrorists and also bribes. Statute also prevents any deductions of payment made in response of blackmail or extortion. So all this kind of money, if the accounts are subtracted, the tax department will add. Is this clear? Then comes the next point. See, capital expenditure. What is capital expenditure? If I buy a building, okay? If I buy a building of 1 million, can I subtract 1 million from here? If I buy a building of 1 million, can I subtract 1 million from here?
No.
No. What I can subtract is revenue expenditure, not capital expenditure. So what I can subtract from here is not depreciation, capital allowances on the building. Can I say? So if you buy a building of 1 million, building is never subtract, even in accounts also. You don't subtract the purchase of building because building is an asset for you. You show where? You show in the statement of financial position. So what do you generally subtract in accounts? You subtract the depreciation. So same for tax. If you buy a building, capital expenditure is not allowed to be subtracted. What is allowed to be subtracted is capital allowances. The purchase of building is not allowed to be subtracted. What is allowed to be subtracted is capital allowances. Depreciation also, I'm not using the word over here. Why? Right? Because he says depreciation I can't do, I will do capital allowances. So see, capital expenditure not deductible. That means not to be subtracted. If they are subtracted, I will add back. Now, this means depreciation is also not deductible. See why? Remember, we used to add depreciation over here. Why? We will add depreciation over here. Why? Because we will subtract capital allowances instead. So instead of subtracting depreciation, I will subtract capital allowances. So I will add back the depreciation in tax and I will subtract the capital allowances instead of depreciation. So that is why they are saying that this means that depreciation is not deductible. Why? Because what is deductible? Capital allowances is deductible. Is this clear? Okay, I hope no one is replying. I hope it is clear now. Still now, then. Remember I gave an example. Profit on sale of machinery, they will add back. What will I do? Subtract? As per tax department, remember, we wrote over here, profit on sale of machinery was 2000. Profit on sale of building and machinery, basically asset, was how much? 2000. And they said the profit was 7000. But they will subtract because see, this 2000 is not trading profit, it is some other profit. Right? So if profit is there, then what will you do? Can I say I will subtract?
Yeah.
And opposite treatment for loss. Loss they will subtract, but this loss is what? Not a trading loss, some other loss. What will I do? I will add. If profit is to be subtracted, loss is to be added. Opposite treatment, that is what says, see profit and loss on sale of non-current assets. Okay? Profit on sale on sale to the profit and loss on sale of non-current assets must be subtracted or added as the case may be. So profit will be what? Profit will be subtracted, loss will be added. Clear? Okay? Now see. Now the most contentious items of expenditure predominantly repairs. Repairs is what? Revenue expenditure, no problem. So if you do a repair, you can subtract. Now you have to understand the expenditure which you are doing is generally a repair or not a repair. Okay, let's see this. Let's see. The cost of restoration of an asset. For instance, replacing a subsidiary part of the asset is revenue expenditure. That means what? Let's see the example. Expenditure on new factory chimney. Replacement was allowable. Allowable means allowed to be subtracted from tax point of view. So expenditure on new factory chimney was allowed to be subtracted since the chimney was a subsidiary part of the factory. That means it is what? Revenue expenditure for you. If it is revenue expenditure, you can subtract. If it is capital expenditure, you can subtract. What you can subtract is capital allowances. Then let's see the next example. Same thing. However, in another case, a football club demolished a spectator stand and replaced it. Now, if you make a spectator stand, is it a revenue expenditure for you or capital expenditure for you?
Capital expenditure.
Capital, right? B expenditure. That means cannot be subtracted. You have to understand from the question only. So it says, however, in case of football club demolished a spectator stand and replaced it with a modern equivalent, this was held to be repaired. This was not meant to be a repair, since repair is the restoration or repair of replacement of subsidiary parts of a larger entity, and the stand formed a distinct and separate portion of the club. That means it was capital expenditure, that is separate. So it was not treated as repairs, it was treated as capital expenses. Is this clear? Then, next, very important. The cost of initial repairs to improve an asset recently acquired to make fit to earn profit is disallowable capital expenditure. Underline the word disallowable capital expenditure. So that means in one word, can I say disallowable capital expenditure means allowable revenue expenditure? Reverse. Not allowed capital expenditure. Instead word disallowable capital expenditure. For that, can I write allowable revenue expenditure? If it is not allowed as capital expenditure, that is what? It is revenue expenditure.
Okay.
Right? So it's negative form of sentence. It says disallowable capital expenditure. It means what? It is allowable revenue expenditure. Okay, now see, very important thing is this. Understand this. They will ask you. What is that? See, understand. If I buy an old building, okay, and it is not good to stay, that means the building is not in a good position. Fine. So if I buy a building, it is not in a good position to stay, and I do some expenditure. That expenditure on the building will be treated as revenue expenditure. I come to my second example. Then I sum it up. I buy a building which is not in a position to stay right now. It is dirty and all those things, right? So I will clean up the building and all those things that I do. So that I will do some expenditure. That expenditure is considered as revenue expenditure. On the other hand, you buy a building. It was perfect in state. That means someone can come and stay over here. But still you did some expenditure for this, maybe some more decorations you have done. That expenditure is not revenue expenditure. So that means the law says, if you buy something and it is in a fit state, that means the state is very good, and then if you do certain expenditure on that, that is not allowed to be subtracted, because the building was already ready for someone to come and stay. Then why did you do extra expenditure? It was not at all allowed, right? That means you did extra expenditure so that you can reduce your profits. More expenditure means what? Less profit. So they are saying, if any asset which is already in a good position, and if you do some expenditure on that, that is not revenue expenditure, you cannot subtract from your profits from here. But if you buy a building and it is not in a good position, and then if you do some expenditure, that expenditure can be subtracted from you. That is what that point says. That is not in detail, but that is what the point means over here. It says the cost of initial repairs to improve the asset. See, that is what. What am I trying to do? I have bought an asset and I am trying to improve it. Improvement means what? It was not in a good state. I am improving it. So if I improve it, it is disallowed capital expenditure. That means what? It is allowed revenue expenditure. Right? So if you do certain expenditure on an asset to improve the position, then what do? You subtract. That means revenue expenditure. But if you buy an asset, it is already in a good state, and then still you forcefully do some expenditure, that is not allowed to be subtracted.
Yeah.
Okay. Then the third one is very easy. The cost of initial repairs to remedy normal wear and tear of recently acquired asset is allowable revenue expenditure. Very simple. That means if you do normal repairs and maintenance of an asset, revenue expenditure only, in accounts only we have the normal repairs and expenditure, all those things are what? Revenue expenditure can be subtracted from your provisions. Okay, so this is fine. Then, exceptions to the capital rule. Cut this, A and B, not important, give up. They will not ask, A and B. Cut that A and B in page number. Actually, let's do it. Never know. But they have never asked for the thing, but still. See, two exceptions to the capital rule. Now, remember we said capital expenditure is not allowed to be subtracted. Yes, we said capital expenditures are not allowed to be subtracted, but there are two exceptions to the rule. One rule is the cost of registering patent and trademarks are deductible. Remember, what is patent and trademark? Is it a fixed asset for me or is it a current asset for me?
Fixed asset.
Fixed. Patent and trademarks, fixed assets?
Yeah.
That means whatever expenditure I do is what? Capital expenditure on them?
Yeah.
But the exception rule is, it says, the cost of registering the patent and trademark is treated as revenue expenditure, not capital expenditure. That is first exception to the rule. Second exception to the rule is, if you want to take a loan of 1 million, for suppose, now if you want to take a loan of 1 million, you have to spend some money for processing fees and all those things. Maybe 1,000, 2,000. That 1,000, 2,000 is revenue expenditure and subtract money. That is point number two. The incidental cost for a loan finance. Incidental cost means small expenses. So if you want to take a loan of 1 million, you are paying 1,000, 2,000 as processing fees. That processing fees can be subtracted from you. Okay. Now, next page. Today is what, 9 or 9:30? Today class till 9 or 9:30?
9.
8:40.
9.
Okay, fine. 9. Tomorrow 9:30, yeah? Because see, all the F7 guys, since there are few people who has just finished F7 with me right now, 5 to 7, and then they're sitting for F6. So it's like 4 hours for them. Hours on their part, no problems. So tomorrow there is no F7. So tomorrow there is no F7. So we will do 7 to 9. Okay. F6 guys, you are already fresh, no problem. Okay, now see, expenditure not only and exclusively for the purpose of trade. That means see, what they are trying to say is that if you do any expenses which are not for business purpose, can I subtract from here? If I do any expenditure which is not for business use, can I subtract from here? Obviously not, because we are trying to find out what? Business profit. So what should come over here is what? Business income and business expenses. So any expenditure which is not business in nature but personal in nature will not be subtracted. For suppose if I tell you that the owner of Executrain spent 10,000 for traveling. Okay, 5,000 was for Executrain purpose and 5,000 was for personal purpose. Okay, that means accounts will do what? Accounts will subtract entire 10,000 from here because it is an expense for you. But what will the tax say? Tax will say, see, 5,000 is good because it is for business use. The other 5,000, that is for what? Personal use. That 5,000 should not be subtracted. That means that 5,000 will be more. We will add that 5,000 from here. Can I say? So any expenditure which you are doing for non-business purpose, remember in WEM, only exclusively and necessarily. In employment income, we spoke about it, right? So any expenditure which you do, which is not only exclusively and necessarily for the business, you add it to the profit. That is what the paragraph 50. Expenditure is not allowed to be subtracted if it is not for trade purpose. Okay? Or it reflects more than one purpose. One purpose means something for private use, something for business use. So bifurcate that. Business use allowed, private use not allowed. The private portion, okay? The private proportion of payments of motoring expenses, rent, heat, light, telephone expenses of a trader is not subtracted. So suppose, see, I tell you this. Exhibition is ground floor and first floor. Okay? Ground floor we are doing classes. First floor, the owner is living over there. Now, when the electricity bill comes, for the entire building it will be the bill. The bill will be for the entire building. Right? Now the entire building electricity bill comes out to be 1,000. So accounts will subtract 1,000 from here. Right? But as per tax purpose, can I say, out of that 1,000 electricity bill, 500 is for executive purpose and 500 is for personal purpose? Because ground floor classes, first floor, personal, they are staying over there. That means the entire bill has to be divided into what? Business use and private use. So that means the other 500 will be added from there. That is what they are saying. The private proportions of the expenses needs to be added back, not deductible. Not deductible means needs to be added back from the tax purpose. Do you agree with this? Then, example one in C. Example A, B, C, D is there and A, B, C, D is there. If you want, you can read. If you don't want, you don't read. No problems. Unimportant. But I will read example one for you. A. See, very good example. The example is something like this. See, understand this. That execute rent. See, understand, very good example. Huh? Execute rent is over here. Okay. Now, one of the clients came to execute rent to meet the owners. Okay. Now, at night, so he could not go back. So at night he was staying not in execute rent, but in the accommodation of execute rent. Theek hai? So situation is something like this, that a client came to meet us. He met at night, he could not travel. So he stayed in our accommodation. Fine. Now, what happened in the accommodation was, maybe the air conditioner fell on him or whatever it is, he broke his hand. Right? Now the customer is, or now the client is saying that for this operation of the hand or whatever it is, you have to pay the bill. So execute rent said fine, no problems. So execute rent paid 5,000 for the operation of that broken hand. Okay? Now, accounts, what will accounts do? They will subtract 5,000 from here because business expense. See the logic. Logic is a client comes or a customer or a client comes to execute rent to meet over here. Right? At night, he goes to the accommodation of execute rent and he is sleeping over there. Something happens, he breaks his hand over there. Okay? Now, executor is taking all the expenses. Executor is bearing all the expenses of his broken hand. That expense comes out to be 5,000. Accounts, they will subtract 5,000 from here. No problems. Now, the tax department, they will ask, this client came to meet executor, right? So, did he break his hand in executor or somewhere else? Or that means, did he break his hand in office building or in other building? It is not an office building. Do you know this? He broke his hand in a competition and it was not office hours. It was what? Late at night. That means the tax department says, this is not a business expenses. You have to add back that 5,000. We can't treat this as an expense now. Okay? This is called one test. This is a test. That means if this guy breaks the hand in execute rate over here in office hours, allowed 5,000, you can subtract, no issues. If he breaks his hand somewhere else, that means in accommodation, not in office hours, not treated as business expenses. If you have subtracted, account has subtracted, the tax will add.
But the accommodation is for execute train, right?
What?
The accommodation will be for execute train, right?
The accommodation is for execute train, but the main purpose is the executor is for giving classes, right? So did he break his hand in office building or room building? If it is office, in office hours, office expenses. If it is outside office hours, not office. You can't fight with this, even if you think that it's illogical, you can't fight court case. That means verdict of the court. So see, that is point number A. It says what? See, a customer was injured by a falling chimney when sleeping in an inn. Sleeping in an inn means IN means hotel. Okay, owned by a brewery. What is brewery? Beer brewing company. Brewery is getting beer brewing company, right? So a customer of a beer brewing company broke his hand or broke his leg, whatever it is, where? In a hotel. That means whatever expenditure I do will not be subtracted. He has to break his hand where? In my own office, in the brewery, right? And so sorry, owned by a brewery claimed compensation from the company. The compensation was not allowed to be subtracted as it did not relate to the trade of innkeeping. That means my business was not hotel, my business was brewery. If my business was hotel, I could have taken that expenses. Since my business was brewery, I cannot take such expenses. Do you get this? Okay, now impairment loss. Impairment loss is basically bad debts. Now bad debt is the only common expenses. Bad debt is the only common expense which is treated similarly over here and treated similarly over here. That means there can never be a problem with bad debts. See, bad debts, you will subtract 1,000. Even he will subtract bad debts 1,000. That means whatever you have done, I will do no treatment of that. That means it is perfectly fine. For rest of the treatment, see, I can say salary is also fine. If salary is 1,000, even he can do salary 1,000. Now see, but if I want, I can give an adjustment of salary. How can I give that adjustment? I will say that this salary was given to wife and generally it should be given at 800. That means what? Can I say 200 will be added over here? Right? That means all the adjustments for all the situations over here can have a difference in treatment based on the situation. But bad debt is the only item wherein the treatment over here and the treatment over here is exactly the same. There can never be any adjustment in bad debts. So if he has subtracted, even I would have done the same thing, I will not do anything then. Right? When do I make the changes? When I only do the changes when you have done something, but I would have done something else, then I do the changes, right? If you have done the same thing as I would have done, I will skip it. So bad debt is the only thing which has common treatment. So if he has subtracted, I will skip, no problem. Okay, but now see, you can say salary, rent also, no problem. But see, if rent is 1,000 and no adjustment is there, that means rent 1,000, we are fine with that. But if I tell you that out of this rent of 1,000, 50% of the building was used for business use, 50% of the building was used for private use, then you will have a problem with that adjustment now. Because now what? 50% allowed, 50% not allowed. So that means rent, salary and all those things can have a change in figures depending on the situation. Bad debts will never have a change in figures. It is always the same. Okay? So that means now see what happens over here. For suppose. If I tell you 6,000 was the gross profit, bad debts was 1,000. So what? 5,000? We will start with what? 5,000 over there also? Will you do any treatment for bad debts? No treatment? Because you have subtracted, even I would have subtracted. That means your treatment is perfectly correct. So 5,000, no problem. Okay? Now, next year, for suppose, this is 1 year. Okay, next year what happens is, this bad debt, which happened last year, now this bad debt, you receive the money. That means the customer came back to you, the customer comes back to you and gives that 1,000 to you. That means what will you do over here? What do you write? Add bad debt recovery of 1,000 and then you will do what? 7,000? Because see, when this 1,000 was bad debt, you subtracted. When you get this money, what do you do? You add back in accounts. Even tax will do the same thing. If there is a bad debt, I will subtract. If I recover the bad debts, I will add, right? That is now the tax will start with what? 6,000 over here. So you have done the same thing. I have also done the same thing. That means what? No treatment at all. So bad debt and bad debt recovery are the two things which will have a no effect over there. That means whatever you have done, I am perfectly fine with this. I will not make a treatment. For the other things, I have to see the question. Rent can be 50-50. Salary can be unpaid after 9 months. Can be more paid to the relative. So that can have adjustments. Fine, penalty, depreciation for sure. Difference in treatment. Other things may have a difference, may not have a difference, depending on the case. But bad debt and bad debt recovery is the only thing which is like a common nature. That means whatever you have done, I am perfectly fine. Agree? So that is basically section 2.3.5. If you understand this section, the entire reading is useless. Clear? Last part, then I stop. Unpaid remuneration. Why I am saying last part, unpaid remuneration? Because I have already discussed this. Remember, unpaid remuneration. When I go to pay my tax, when will I go to pay my tax? 31st January 2021. Yes? So HMRC will ask me that did you pay the salary? If I say yes, he says fine. If I say no, they will do what? Add back the unpaid remuneration. Remember, they said the same thing that once it says if the earnings of the employees are charged in accounts but are not paid within 9 months of the end of the period. That is, what is 9 months? See, when are we ending? April 6th, right? From there, if you add April 6th is as good as 31st March. So if you add 9 months from there, you will come to 31st January 2021. That is the date when we pay the tax. That is the date when we pay the tax. That was the writing line. Why did it write 31st January over here? Because I have never spoken like what is 31st January. So they are saying 9 months. Basically, that is 31st January 2021, the day when I pay the tax which I want. Okay? So if it is not paid within the 9 months of the end of the period, the cost is only deductible for the period of account in which the earnings are paid. That means what? I will add that and I will only subtract when it is actually paid. Maybe after 2 years, 3 years, 4 years. So this year I will add back. When you pay it next year, after year, whatever it is, then I will subtract. Okay, then it says when tax computation is made, see they are saying when tax computation is made within 9 months period, it is initially assumed that unpaid earnings will not be paid within that period, the computation is adjusted if they are so paid. So if it is not paid, we adjust. If it is paid, no problems. Okay, then no problems, then no issues. Then entertaining and gifts, very important is exciting, lease charges, very exciting. See, you everything will make sense. When next class, I will do that sum of page 113. Everything will start making sense, a bit of sense, and it will, you will get a structure to whatever I have discussed till now, because till now it is theory. I thought I could finish till 113, but I think we started late, so no problem. So, if once I do this sum on page 113, I will do this entire sum of the board, 113, and you will do it with me in the copy also, so that you understand. Okay?
Are we going back to orders?
What?
Are we doing each chapter or did you skip to chapter 7?
I didn't get it.
Like how many chapters have we finished till now for F6?
My god, where were you? We have finished 7 chapters.
Okay.
We have finished number 2, number 3, number 4, number 5, number 6, and we are doing number 7 right now. And we have finished chapter number 12 also.
Okay.
Now, so that means I will do this 113 with you. Now, if you understand this, I can do verbally also. If you don't understand, I will do on the board. Once I do this sum, you will get a complete idea or a structure that, okay, how it is done. Okay, it will start making a bit sense. So, a few more explanations. Once that is done, then I think, once I teach this sum, then I will only take 1 hour to finish this chapter. So, basically, see, my quota will be to finish this chapter tomorrow. So if I finish by 9, we leave the class. Maximum we can go is 9:30, not more than that. Okay, so if I finish before 9, well enough. If I don't finish before 9, then let's see what can happen. But maximum we should finish this by next class. Okay, now for this week and next week, be ready for regular classes. Maybe 4 days, maybe 5 days. Can happen. Okay, because this is the time we can cover up. See, if this continues like this, if we do like this only, so then it's better to finish the syllabus as fast as possible and do more of a practice. So then you will do more of a practice. So practice will make everything clear over you. Okay? Now what I am telling you is, since you have got the soft copy with you, so for every chapter, you know, you start studying. So do chapter number 2, you will have, when you come to the end of the chapter, you will have that box. Remember I showed you a box of question And that box question, end of the chapter, of chapter number 2, for suppose. So if you finish the chapter, you come to chapter number 2. When you come to chapter number 2, then you will find a box will be there, and there will be given question number 1, 2, 3, 4, there will be questions. And beside the question, they will give you marks, 2 marks, right? So please try that 2 marks question. Where will you get the questions? Right at the end of the book. Right? So refer to that question numbers, go to the end of the book, do the question. Where will you get the answer? Again at the end of the book. Once that question ends, you will find the book answers at the end. So you can refer to the answer now. So start practicing those sums from the book at least. So, but you cannot directly do the sums unless you read the chapter. Please read the chapter, go and do the sums. Any problem, click the photo, give it to me. Or ask me, no problems. Okay? So this small steps you have to start taking now. So it's high time, mid of March. So high time. So start taking that small steps. Finish chapter 2, do the small, only 2 more questions, please do not try that 10 more questions. Only the 2 more questions. Okay, do that small question so you get an idea of it. Okay, so next, most probably tomorrow sharp will start at 7 o'clock. Now today we have all those issues. Hopefully tomorrow will not have the issue because you get that feeling now. So 6:45, they will share you the link. Okay, so 6:45 you get the link, 7 o'clock will start. Fine. So please read this chapter once again if you have any doubt. Plus minus effect is very important. 15 mark question from this chapter only. Okay, not from this chapter, but this is the structure of the chapter. Even depreciation you have to find separately. That is next chapter. But this plus minus effect will be there in the 15 mark question for sure. Not 15, basically 30. Why I'm saying 30? 15 marks for disappeared will be what for individual. The same plus minus we will even do for companies also. That means 115 mark work for a company, 115 mark for individuals. That means 30 marks work from which plus minus you will get. So this plus minus effect which you are learning over here will not go waste because again in companies we will do the same thing. All the plus minus effect. Okay, so let's do that sum tomorrow 1:13 and then structure that okay how it is done. Okay, so any questions before I end or should we end? So tomorrow 7 o'clock.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. Bye, sir.
And they will share you this video also tomorrow. They will save it today, and then all these videos which we are doing, they will share in the WhatsApp group. So by tomorrow, you will get this video once again in your WhatsApp. Okay.
Thank you, sir.